This is the new video course that we are starting today. It is regarding the Azure Container Registry. If you are aware about the containerization concepts like Docker, Kubernetes, and the containerization terminologies like image, pull, push, what are the repository, what are the registry, this is not the Windows registry that we are talking about here that you see on the Windows server. It is the different concept of the containerization that originally was came from Docker or the Kubernetes, which was developed by Google probably a decade ago. But nowadays Docker is an open source technology that has been available on Azure in the form of Azure Container Registry that is managed by the Azure platform from the backend. So with the course that moving on, introduction to private Docker container registries in Azure. Azure Container Registries allows you to build, store and manage images for all types of container deployments. Okay, what is the difference between container and the usual VM approach that we use? Let's say I am running 3 VMs on a hypervisor. 1, 2, 3. So to all of these 3 VMs, I will assign RAM, CPU, RAM, CPU, RAM, and CPU, which would be initially allocated from the host on which they are running. And every time this machine will be up or not running, I have my RAM and CPU allocated to all the VMs, whether or not they are on or off, they are in use or not. But this is not with the containerization concept. It directly run on the host, or let's say the kernel of your host, and it contained all the libraries, executables, dependencies, and the application in a single container. Right. So, for example, the goods that are imported from another country to India, some of them come through from the plane, some of them come through land, but most of them comes on a ship and we have a container. So they pack the stuff from the location and the stuff is unpacked onto the destination, right? That is how the container works in the computing environment as well. Container would contain all the dependencies, libraries, executables, functions, and the application inside a container that would help it to become an image. So there would be no discrepancies when you would be executing an application on any environment. We face an issue wherein one person says that, okay, the application runs on my computer or on my server. Then another person says that it's not running on my computer. There are certain things that would be missing. Let's say you are building a Tomcat application. You would be using Tomcat 7 to build the test environment. I may or may not be using Tomcat 7. So that application that you have made would not run on my server or on my machine because I was not using the Tomcat version. So now if I would have used container image, it would have bring in all the dependencies, executables, and the libraries with itself, and it would not depend on my version of the Tomcat. It would build the Tomcat 7 or the Tomcat Docker image itself and run this. So there would be no chance of that containerized image failing on at my end as well. So I hope you got my point. I will explain in the future sections as well. Now the Azure Container Registry is a managed Docker registry service based on the open source Docker registry that we just discussed. You can create and maintain Azure Container Registries to store and manage your private Docker container images. So registry is a platform wherein you store your container images. You make repositories inside your registries, container registries, and in those repositories you store your container images. So what is Docker? Docker is a containerization platform that packages your application and all its dependencies together in the form of a Docker container to ensure that your application works seamlessly in any environment. So you now got my point, what I was just explaining a few seconds ago. What is a container? A Docker container is a standardized unit which can be created on the fly to deploy a particular application or environment. It could be an Ubuntu container, a CentOS container, to fulfill the requirement from an operating system point of view, like I gave you the Tomcat example. So it can, you can be a Tomcat container as well. You can create a Tomcat container by pulling in the Tomcat Docker image from the Docker hub, or let's say Docker registry, and then you would create an image using the container, Docker container, on the fly to fulfill the operating system requirement. It could be an application oriented container like Cake PHP container or Tomcat Ubuntu container or etc. Registry. Create one or more container registries in your Azure subscription. So now, what all we discussed regarding the Docker and container, that is applicable to all the cloud environments that would be integrating the Docker. But when you come to the registry, it says you can, we can create one or more container registries in the Azure subscriptions. Prerequisite would be that you should have an Azure subscription. Registries are available in three SKUs. Configuration, you would, on the basis of what they charge you, basic, standard and premium, each of which support webhook integration, registry authentication with Azure Active Directory and delete functionality. We can take advantages of local network cloud storage of your container images by creating a registry in the same Azure location as the deployments. We can use the geo-replication feature of premium registries. So the geo-replication feature is only available in the premium registries. For advanced replication and container image distribution scenarios, let's say you want to enable the replication of your container image from one geo-replical region to another, you can use the premium version and enable the geo-replication. A fully qualified registry name has the form myregistry.azure.io. So it, my registry, it can be named, you can name anything, but the postfix would be .azurecr. Azure Container Registry.io. Repository. As I told you, registry contains one or more repositories which store groups of container images. Azure Container Registry supports multi-level repository namespaces. With multi-level namespaces, you can group collections of images related to a specific app or a collection of apps to specific development or operational teams. Images stored in a repository. Each image is a read-only snapshot of a Docker-compatible container. Azure Container Registries can include both Windows and Linux images. You control image names for all of your container deployment. You control image names for all of your container deployments. You use standard Docker commands to push images into a repository or pull an image from a repository. In addition to container image, Azure Container Registry stores related content formats such as Helm charts used to deploy application to Kubernetes. Container. A container defines a software application and its dependencies wrapped in a complete file system, including code, runtime, system tools and libraries. Run Docker containers based on Windows or Linux images that you pull from a Docker container registry. Containers running on a single machine shares the operating system kernel. Docker containers are fully portable to all major Linux distros, Mac OS and Windows. So if we do a brief recap, registry would be, you create the registry of any SKU that you want, integrate it for the authentication with Azure Active Directory. Then you would create a repository. A registry contains, in which you will store your container images or a group of container images. And then you would have the images. The images are stored in a repository. Each image is a read-only snapshot of a Docker compatible container. So the Docker compatible container helps you pull out an image from the repository to make it a Docker compatible instance, containerization instance of a Docker compatible container. Then you have the container, right? So you would have the registry, in that side you have repository, in that you would have an image to be a read-only snapshot of a Docker compatible container. Then you would have a container, container would define a software application and its dependencies. Remember, I told you, container is the one which holds all the goods that are coming from one location to another. So in our case, the container defines the software application and its dependencies. So dependencies are the code, runtime, system tools, and libraries, which are the goods coming from one location to another. Run Docker containers based on Windows or Linux images that you pull from a container registry. Right. And that's the end. So I hope you all had a very good understanding about what all we would be covering in this video course. So I hope you liked this section. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel, like all the videos. Please share your feedbacks in the comment section. And I see you with more exciting stuff regarding this course in the next video. Till then, have a great day. Bye-bye.